Come on and put your hands together. We singing a song that you should all know. It says, Lord, you are good. Here we go. Make some noise today. All right, here we go, family. Say, Lord.
Lord, you are good and your mercy enduring forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy enduring forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy enduring forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy enduring forever. From generation to generation, we worship you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you for who you are.
Let's say that again, we worship.
We worship you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship.
Let's take it back to the top. Say, Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. People from every nation and tongue, from generation to generation, we worship you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you for who you are.
Let's say that again, we worship.
We worship you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you for who you are. You are good.
Come on and put your hands together. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Say, you are.
You are good all the time. All the time. You are good. You are good all the time. All the time. You are good.
Stay right there. Say that again.
You are good. All the time, all the time, you are good, you are good. All the time, all the time, you are good.
Say you are good.
All the time, all the time, you are good, you are good. All the time, all the time, you are good. You are good all the time, all the time. You are good, you are good all the time, all the time. You are good.
Say people.
People from every nation and tongue, from generation to generation, we worship you. Hallelujah.
What a blessing it is to be able to stand before you in this virtual way on this last Sunday in the year 2020. Thanks be to God that we can worship the Lord and we can communicate in a different way, and His word is still coming forth and coming through.
Yeah.
So many things we continue to anticipate and we look forward to, though Christmas Day has come and is now days behind. We still have things to look forward to,
yeah,
because with God, we always have something that He's still about to usher in. Thank goodness for His continued grace and mercy. There was a word I like to lift up on this particular Sunday from the Gospel of Luke, the second chapter of Luke's Gospel, verses 25 through 30. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon, and this man was just and devout, looking for the consolation of Israel. and the Holy Spirit was upon him. And it had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he should not see death before he had seen the Lord's Christ. And inspired by the Spirit, he came into the temple. And when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him according to the custom of the law, he looked up in his arms and blessed God and said, "Lord, now lettest thy servant depart in peace according to thy word, for mine eyes have seen thy salvation." Seeing is relieving. Seeing is relieving. The thoughts of anticipating something and finally being able to behold it and experience it is quite an amazing experience. People of faith are accustomed to leaning forward in God's direction in hope that he fulfills some long-cherished dream, some long-cherished belief, or that this is the time that some prophecy would be fulfilled in your lifetime.
All right.
Much can be said about the process of standing with tiptoed expectation. However, when the anticipation is based on something foretold concerning God, when the time, when the place, and the moment is right, God delivers.
Amen.
There was a man whom I view as the epitome of what it means to believe God and trust him to fulfill his word. Simeon was a man of high regard in Jerusalem and the first to be called by the title of Rabbi. He succeeded his father Hillel as president of the college which his father founded and of the great Sanhedrin Council. With all of his accomplishments, with all of his lofty standings among his people, he wasn't so high up till he failed to look for spiritual realities beyond himself. Simeon was a just and devout man. In other words, he was full of justice and devotion. He was just towards other people and fully devoted to God. You know, there is a definite connection between justice towards other people and devotion to God. The two are inseparable. Justice towards other people and devotion for God are, in the words of the philosopher, inextricably bound together, and it is evidence of true religion. When it comes to our dealings with one another, being just and fair and respectful belongs in the midst of the heart of anybody who claims to love God. As the philosopher Martin Buber said, there is a connection, there is an I-thou relationship, and there's an I-you relationship. I can have my I-thou relationship and love God all day and all night, but unless I can have an I-you relationship that shows that I love you and care about you and have respect for you, then it's hard to say I love God and not the people that he created. And in this era when there were so many inequities, when there were so many divisions that were sown in the hearts of an entire nation, I do believe it's time for us to make sure that the I-thou relationship hooks up with the I-you relationship. And unity becomes the way of dealing in our world once again. Simeon was a man who was just in his dealings with other people and lived a life purely devoted to God. And during the season of waiting with anticipation for the day of God's appearance in human flesh, he believed the time was nigh and waited with tiptoed anticipation for an indication from God concerning that which was foretold. It took many millenniums. It took many years before the pre-existent Son of God would enter into our mortality. Those who believe in the coming of Christ continued waiting and desiring his reality in our humanity with hope and with patience. Simeon was such a man. He had faith in Christ's coming that was according to knowledge. He understood it by the prophetic books like Daniel, that the time was at hand, and was now more than ever standing with expectation, watching with each sunrise for the day of his appearing. As he waited and hoped for the day when the Lord, when the Word would become flesh and dwell among us, while he waited for the fulfillment of the prophecy about a virgin bearing birth to a son, the Holy Spirit came upon him. Surely when the Holy Spirit comes upon us, it enables us to speak and remember things which we have learned earlier, things which come to us from above. One day, the Holy Spirit revealed to Simeon an utterance accompanied by an assurance that he should not see death before he had seen the Lord's Christ. He shall not see death before he had seen the Messiah, the Lord's anointed. And you know, God has a way of reminding us that there are some things in our lifetimes that we will see during our day that he has promised. There are a whole lot of things that we will see. Maybe some answered prayers we'll see. Maybe we'll see ourselves getting through some jams and getting through a crisis that we didn't think we would see. But the Lord says we will see it before we close our eyes and depart this world. Yeah. God knew of Simeon's desire as expressed in a song that we sing around here very often. Oh, I want to see him and look upon his face. And just when the lives of four individuals were synchronized by the Spirit as God prepared to order their steps, a divine rendezvous was prearranged between Simeon, Mary, Joseph, and a little baby wrapped in swaddling clothes. Unbeknownst to them, the Spirit ordered their steps to meet in the Jerusalem temple for a reason beyond themselves. Yeah. Simeon, moved by the unction of the Spirit, arrived at the temple and started worshiping God. The Lord had him prepositioned in the right place and at the right time to fulfill some foretold realities. You know, just as the Lord had Simeon prepositioned for some things that were about to happen, so he prepositions us as well. Oh, he has us at the right place, at the right time, because this is the time when there's something that he said, something he's spoken into your life, and now is the time for it to happen, and it has you prepositioned already. Yeah. Oh, I can read about Simeon, and I can get happy on the inside, because if the Lord did it for Simeon about some things that he would see while he was still in this world, I'm sure he does it for us. So Simeon was prepositioned, and he was worshiping God in the temple. After a while, he noticed the entrance of a man and a woman with an infant child coming into the service. You know, they could still meet then because they weren't socially distanced like we are now, but they were still able to come in and be safe and sound. Joseph and Mary brought the child in to be registered in the church book among the firstborn. And as Simeon gazed at the couple with interest and focused on the child with a growing curiosity, no doubt he experienced the same sentiment the songwriter of later years captured in the lyrics. He saw this child and he knew what the Spirit told him. He didn't really know that that was the child. But the lyrics said, "What child is this who is laid to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet while shepherds watch are keeping? This is Christ the King, the babe, the son of Mary." So Simeon stepped over and drew closer to look into the face of a newborn baby he was led to see. Oh, he wasn't around when the baby was there in the stall. Wasn't there when the baby was born and laid in a manger like the shepherds were. This was a little bit of time later. But you know, when he went over to see, he noticed something special about this child. Yeah. This was no ordinary baby. When Simeon looked upon the face of infant Jesus, he saw one who was the Ancient of Days. He saw a life that was older than time itself in the form of a baby. Yeah. I say that because Jesus is the pre-existent Son of God. That wasn't the beginning of his life. He was always with the Father. He came, the Word became flesh. He came to be in our humanity in the form of a baby. And when Simeon exchanged glances with the one that was wrapped inside of an ancient blanket, he saw more than meets the eye. He saw embodied in one child, a child who had multiple dimensions. And he was destined to be many people, be many things to many people. He was already destined to be much and more than just one expression of life. To some, he would be the mighty counselor. To some, he would be known as the mighty God and the everlasting Father. To others, he would be the Prince of Peace, whose government would never stop increasing, nor would it ever end. No wonder Simeon was moved till he took the tiny baby in his arms and he blessed God, saying, "Lord, now lettest thy servant depart in peace according to your word. for mine eyes have seen your salvation. You know, we too can say like Simeon did in our day and time, Lord, lettest thy servant depart the month of December in peace according to your word. Lord, lettest thy servant get ready to leave the year 2020 in peace, because we are reminded of your salvation, and we're beginning to find your miracles in the month of December. I can leave December and I can leave 2020 pretty soon because mine eyes have seen your salvation. Anybody in here ever had a prayer answered during 2020? You can say, now lettest thy servant depart 2020 in peace because mine eyes have seen thy salvation. You know, if you are still able to survive and you are still able to make it on through, you can say, now, Lord, lettest thy servant depart in peace because mine eyes have seen thy salvation. I have a brand new attitude, all because I can trust in your word. I have a renewed faith because I'm getting through some stuff I didn't think I'd get through at all. Lord, now I have seen your salvation. And now that you're beginning to bring, this pandemic to the end, at least with some hope in our minds, Lord, we have seen your salvation, and I believe it will carry on over and it will carry on through. I don't know how you feel about it, but I can leave this day, I can leave this moment knowing that I can still trust in the Lord. He can keep us going. Oh, yes, he can. And he can keep us hoping in him. Oh, yes, he can. And I know he can keep us moving. Yes, he can. And yes, we will. And you know what? As long as we're living in the world, he'll keep on showing up and doing great things for us. And then if we have to close our eyes because we met our time, we can depart in peace because we know that he got everything already prepared. Seeing is relieving. Seeing the Lord's movement, seeing the evidence of his presence, it's relieving. Be relieved. Leave December. Get ready for another year, knowing that God still is moving in the presence of all of us, making it better for us as time keeps marching on. Seeing is relief.
Falling in love with Jesus, falling in love with Jesus, falling in love with Jesus. Was the best thing I've ever done. In his arms, I feel protected. In his arms, never did connected. In his arms I feel protected. There's no place I'd rather rather be.
Heavenly Father, we come before you once again, and during the last Sunday worship experience of this 2020 year, we certainly lift up our prayers to you, and we come together and reflect over much and many things. Hear our prayers wherever we are, as we stop doing what we were doing, and we look over our lives, and we know that there were many things we were able to see, all because of your guiding hand. If we take the time and reflect, we can surely depart from one day to the next and be at peace, knowing that we have seen your hand move in our affairs. Hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, as we pray one household to another, individually and as families, we ask your blessing upon us in a great way. We know that you're able to continue to usher in blessings, and it doesn't stop now that the December month has come and is on its way across the vaulted dome. We continue to bless you for all that you've done, and we continue to look forward to the other things you have to usher into our life experience while we are still in this world. Let it be, O Lord, that we're able to appreciate each and every day, each and every experience with thanksgiving and praise always. Let it be, O Lord, that we continue worshiping you, having a stronger faith in you, a stronger belief in your ability to see us through. We ask your blessings upon us, whatever we are asking for collectively, individually, in different homes and households. Hear our prayers, O Lord. Incline your ear to us and grant us with thy peace. As we move forward during the month of January, the Board of Christian Education and the Sunday School Ministries have come together to plan a virtual general Bible study and Sunday school at the same time during the month of January, about the second week, I believe. We will have the Bible study on Wednesday, the second week, and then we'll have the Sunday school on that Sunday of the second same week. We'll be talking about this once again on a watch night service. We'll make mention of it once again, and even on the first Sunday, this is the time we'll be mentioning it again before we get to it. God's blessing be upon you. And now unto him who is able to keep you from falling and present you faultless before his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be grace, power, and dominion henceforth, now, and forevermore. Amen, 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 amen. Amen. May you continue to see God's blessings. And each time you see it, let it be more relieving each time you experience his movement. God's blessing be upon you.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.